Good evening. Jesus said, "Peace I leave with you, my own peace I give to you. Not as the world gives, but the way I give to you. Let not your hearts be troubled, and neither let them be afraid." Over the past few months and weeks, it has become more and more difficult to not let our hearts be troubled and afraid. It seems as though we are beset on all sides by violence, racism, division, and so we thought that maybe tonight we would take a moment and pause and join together here and online in prayer. Tonight we will focus three separate litanies throughout the service on gun violence, on racism, and on division. And the proper response at the end of each period is, "Have mercy upon us." Hear now these words from our Lord Christ, the Gospel of Luke. Jesus returned in the power of the Spirit to Galilee, and news about him spread throughout the whole countryside. He taught in their synagogues and was praised by everyone. Jesus went to Nazareth, where he had been raised. On the Sabbath, he went to the synagogue as he normally did and stood up to read. The synagogue assistant gave him the scroll from the prophet Isaiah. He unrolled the scroll and found the place where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to preach good news to the poor, to proclaim release to the prisoners and recovery of sight to the blind, to liberate the oppressed and to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor." He rolled up the scroll, gave it back to the synagogue assistant, and sat down. Every eye in the synagogue was fixed upon him. He began to explain to them, "Today, this scripture has been fulfilled, just as you have heard it."
Lord, have mercy.
Draw me near, Isaiah 2, verses 1 through 4. This is what Isaiah, Amoz's son, saw concerning Judah and Jerusalem. In the days to come, the mountain of the Lord's house will be the highest of the mountains. It will be lifted above the hills. Peoples will stream to it. Many nations will go and say, "Come, let's go up to the Lord's mountain, to the house of Jacob's God, so that he may teach us his ways, and we may walk in God's paths." Instruction will come from Zion, the Lord's word from Jerusalem. God will judge between the nations and settle disputes of mighty nations. Then they will beat their swords into iron plows and their spears into pruning tools. Nation will not take up sword against nation. They will no longer learn how to make war. Giver of life and love, you created all people as one family and called us to live together in peace. Surround us with your love as we face again the tragedies of gun violence, racial animosity, and division.
Have mercy upon us.
We confess our fascination with guns and weapons that have for far too long claimed the lives of the undefended, the vulnerable, and especially children who have been wounded and killed in acts of random terror in a nation founded on the promise to protect life, liberty, and pursuit of happiness.
Have mercy upon us.
We confess how we have too often appealed to your name and that of the name of Jesus to justify our right to defend and protect, even when you gave up your defenses and even died on the cross to rise again, destroying the powers of sin and death.
Have mercy upon us.
O Lord, we remember for you all those whose lives have been ended or shattered by gun violence. For Columbine, Virginia Tech, Sandy Hook, Aurora, Mother Emanuel Church, Pulse Nightclub, the Trinity Life Synagogue, Marjory Stoneman Douglas High School, Las Vegas, El Paso Walmart, Massage Spas in Atlanta, the King Supers in Boulder, for the nearly 20,000 lives ended by gun violence last year, and for so many more that we now name in our hearts.
reading from the prophet Micah. With what shall I approach the Lord and bow down before God on high? Should I come before him with entirely burnt offerings, with year-old calves? Will the Lord be pleased with thousands of rams and many torrents of oil? Should I give my oldest child for my crime, the fruit of my body for the sin of my spirit? He has told you, human one, what is good and what the Lord requires from you. To do justice, embrace faithful love, and walk humbly with your God. Oh Lord, for the times when we have failed to recognize racism in ourselves, in our church, in our society, in the times we have failed to take action, for our complicity in systems of privilege and power which harms those whose skin colors, cultures, or creeds differ from our own, have mercy upon us. Grant us patience in enduring periods of non-action, persistence in resisting the evil of radical oppression, and faithfulness in working toward racial justice among your people, in the church, and in the world, we pray. Have mercy upon us. We remember all of those communities damaged by racism, and all lives ended too soon because of it. For Emmett Till, Clifford Glover, Randolph Evans, Claude Reese, Yvonne Smallwood, Manu Diallo, Oscar Grant, Trayvon Martin, Jordan Davis, Ayanna Jones, Renisha McBride, Tamir Rice, Walter Scott, Freddie Gray, Sandra Bland, Brianna Taylor, Philando Castile, Jordan Edwards, Stefan Clark, Eric Gardner, Alton Jean, Tatiana Jefferson, Ahmaud Arbery, George Floyd, Adam Toledo, far too many more, those that we remember within our own hearts now. For the souls of all those departed too soon, Lord, we pray, have mercy upon us.
Oh.
beer for all peoples, a rich feast, a feast of choice wines, of select foods rich in flavor, of choice wines well learned. He was swallowed up on this mountain, veiled and veiled on peoples, the shroud of shrouding all nations. He will swallow up death forever. The Lord God will wipe tears from every face. He will remove his people's disgrace from off the whole earth. For the Lord has spoken. They will say on that day, look, this is our God, for whom we have waited. And he has saved us. This is the Lord, for whom we have waited. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation. We confess the times we have made enemies out of those we disagree with politically or theologically. We've often failed to see the image of God in them, and we have failed to love them as Christ first loved us.
Have mercy on us.
For the idol we have made of our political beliefs, for the idol we have made of our orthodoxy, for the myriad of sins we commit in degrading others to make ourselves feel
have mercy upon us.
O blessed God of the prophets, guide us to have the honest, difficult conversations about what truly drives our fears. Protect the voices of those whom you have called to speak the truth to the powerful. Comfort those of us who have endured harm and discomfort those of us who have contributed to that harm.
Have mercy upon us.
Give us courage for the facing of this hour. Guide us by the bright vision of your kingdom, where no weapon is strong, no division known, no strength known but the strength of love, and where every tear is wiped away.
Have mercy upon us.
Now take a moment for silent prayers and lift your hearts to God.
Friends, although we find ourselves in a broken world, a world in which hurting people far too often hurt others, we come longing for healing. We have gathered to pray for peace, and not only that, but we also come pledging to reverse the conditions that have produced such violence and destructive behavior that have torn the fabric of our families and our communities. Today we gather together to express our unity and our commitment. We stand as one people against the violence and hatred which has touched every corner of our lives. We commit ourselves to journey on the path toward a more perfect peace. Peace in all our homes, houses of worship, schools and places of education, our towns and our cities. More perfect peace, where swords are beat into crooning cheers, where the sound of gunfire is stilled, a place where there is no us and them, but simply us. I invite you guys, with a little bit of music, to exit in a spirit of prayer. Continue tonight praying, asking and listening for how you can contribute to that more perfect peace. And that you would love.